We see that a given composite section is such that the centroidal axis of composite section does not pass through the centroidal axis of these two steel sections. So we need to convert this composite section into either an equivalent steel section or equivalent wood section. So for convenience, we will be converting this into an equivalent steel section. So we convert this composite wooden steel section into an equivalent steel section by reducing the width of wood given by the formula B. Width of equivalent steel is equal to width of wood upon M. So this is equal to width of wood ES upon EW. So this is equal to width of wood is 150 mm, this whole upon ES is 200 into 10 to the power 3 upon EW is 20 into 10 to the power 3. So we get the value of equivalent width of steel part as 15 mm, whereas the dimensions of the remaining actual steel part remain same, that is 150 mm width and thickness as 10 mm. So now your equivalent steel section is also a symmetrical section where your centroidal xx axis passes through the same center of this equivalent steel section. So your ymax of steel and ymax of wood, which is actually the ymax of equivalent steel part, will remain same. So now let's find out the moment of resistance of this composite section, which will be equal to the moment of resistance of this equivalent steel section. So now if you write the equation of bending of the composite beam, we have bending moment maximum is equal to moment of resistance of composite beam. Now this is equal to the moment of resistance of equivalent steel section. So we can write as bending moment maximum is equal to sigma max by y max of equivalent steel section into moment of inertia of same equivalent steel section about its centroidal axis, which is also your neutral axis. So now upon substituting the values, we have bending moment maximum is phi into 10 to the power 6 newton mm is equal to sigma max of equivalent steel section is nothing but sigma max of the steel part of this equivalent steel section, which is at the extreme top layer. So this we have been asked to find out. So let this be sigma max of steel upon y max of this steel or this equivalent steel section is same, which is 135 mm. The moment of inertia of equivalent steel section can be given as the moment of inertia of this bigger rectangle of width 150 mm and depth of 250 plus 10 plus 10 is equal to 270 mm minus the moment of inertia of two small rectangles whose width is 67.5 mm and depth is 250 mm. So we can write this as 150 mm multiplied by 270 cube by 12, which is the moment of inertia of bigger rectangle, minus of 2 times of moment of inertia of small rectangle, which is 67.5 mm into 250 cube by 12. Upon solving this, we get the value of sigma max of steel equal to 9.6 newton per mm square.